Joining us now for his take on what this still sticky inflation reading, although not as hot as expected, could mean for the BSP, for rates, markets, and for the economy is Jonas Reveles of eMethods for Business Management Corp, or EMBM. Jonas, hi. Welcome to Market Edge.
Good morning, Mimi. Well, it's a good number. I think this is now the second print that is
decelerating.
However, yes, I think the key issue here is hopefully we get to see below 7% in for April. And this is actually going to be a good sign. The only thing is that core inflation remains high at 8%. So I don't think the BSP is finished with its rate hikes, although it could be a smaller rate hike, which what we've seen of 25 basis points. So probably we could see another maybe two more hikes, probably closer to 7%. And hopefully we don't get affected by the rise in oil prices. Although we government has already highlighted it will have not much material impact, but I guess it really depends on how the global markets will shape, especially that you know, it's going to be summer season in the US soon, so basically we will probably see a lot of demand for oil, and probably given the low prices, that could also create some stockpiling by G7 countries that could you know, be worried about this cut in
output by the OPEC Plus producers.
Yes.
So, Jonas, that's actually my question. We are an importing country. We import oil. So when you've got oil abroad spiking because of this surprise million barrel cut by OPEC Plus producers happening starting May all throughout the rest of the year, do you think that the print that we got for March is moot and academic, that it might not be sustainable?
Well, I think what we have is a sticky inflation. Mm-hmm. I think what the numbers are telling us that probably we are plateauing in terms of inflation, but it will still take time before we get to see the inflation going back to the upper band of the central bank,
which is 4%.
So given that first, yes, which is still 4%. So an average of 8.3 is still high from the, we still need to bring it down by 4.3%. So it will take two things. One, the monetary side, which is eventually kicking and doing the heavy lifting, would probably mean additional hikes, just like what we're going to be expecting from the US Fed. At the same time, the non-monetary tools, which is what the government is already implementing, is slowly materializing, but it's not as fast compared to monetary policy. So probably we will probably see inflation closer to that 4%, probably not in 2023.
Could it be 2024?
Possibly in the first half of 2024.
All right. Jonas, I'm very curious. I was looking at the range of estimates from analysts, and you were at the top end of the inflation forecast spectrum. You were looking at 8.5%. Particularly, what did we miss? What surprised you with the reading today?
Basically, it was more of the food.
More of the food. All
because,
right.
Because I think more of the food, because for a while, most of the agriculture in January and Feb were still high. So again, as I said, the non-monetary tools will really take time in probably to see the effect. So probably this is, I think, one for the first time since this inflation part two, that we've really seen the impact of the government strategy.
All right. And Jonas, does a slowing inflation also bring down the odds of a recession or a slowdown?
In a way, but you see, we have other factors to consider on the global front. So I guess despite that, probably the the banking crisis in the US of East, recession concerns remains, and you know, US is also battling, and the rest of the world is battling this global inflation.
Mm-hmm. And Jonas, so I get that you're expecting two more 25 basis point rate hikes before the BSP calls it a day. So that brings a peak rate at 6.75%, closer to 7. The changing of the guard that's going to be happening at the Banco Central come July, do you see that factoring into the equation, or do you think that's a non-event?
Oh, I think it's a non-event.
All right.
I think more of the expectation is going to be more of continuity, mm-hmm. Just like what we saw, the transfer from former BSP governor Jokno to BSP, to the current governor Medalla. So whoever will most likely succeed or take over the seat will most likely continue with the same policies.
Mm-hmm. Jonas, just very quickly, are there names that you're hearing already this early for replacement? Could the finance secretary go back to BSP? I mean, he's so passionate and he's been talking about rates as well.
Well, basically, I guess we've always been hearing the finance secretary, and of course there are others looking at the fresh term for the present governor. So I think it would be best to probably, from my personal view, is to eventually give a fresh term to the present governor.
All right. So to keep this present governor and give him a fresh term instead of just finishing the term left, the unexpired term of Secretary Jokno.
Yes. Ah. I think at this point in time, it's so difficult to change the captain when you're slowly pivoting to an economic recovery.
All right.
And so, I think, you know, you have the finance secretary well placed to probably provide guidance for the economic recovery.
All right. On that note, Jonas, always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for taking the time and for the instant analysis. See you soon.
See you. Bye.
All right.